हॉस्टल का जो फ्रेशर्स इवेंट होता है उसमें जो मिस्टर फ्रेशर बनता है तो वो करता है पूजा इस वैलेंटाइन डे के दिन। वैलेंटाइन डे वाले दिन पुजारी आता है हॉस्टल और कॉलेज के लड़कों के साथ, हीरो और एक हीरोइन, जो जिन्होंने इस साल काम अच्छा किया है। एक दमदमी माई होती है, एक दमदमी पिता होते हैं और बेसिकली वहाँ एक पूजा होती है।
दे से दैट द कॉन्डम इफ इट फॉल्स ऑन एनीवनस हेड that person will get laid and will get a girlfriend in the next 6 months.
The concept behind condoms has always been the awareness regarding sex related problems, the diseases which are associated with. So there is very this noble idea behind the entire idea of condoms. So I don't think it's anything sexist.
Do we want to be worshipped or do we want a space where we can also express our sexuality in a positive manner?
It has been going on from 1953, if I'm not wrong. And the boys' hostel people say that it's a tradition and it's something that Hindu college is known for.
Bollywood actress ke photo lagai jati hai and they wo log pray karte hai ki unki virginity lose ho jaye.
This goddess is decided by the hostel union by vote. So if we actually simplify it, it's basically a bunch of men sitting and commenting on a woman's body and picking the most perfect body to hang on a tree and objectify as well as worship.
First of all, if in 2019 a college is known for a very sexist and misogynistic Brahminical practice, then I don't think that it is something we need to be proud of.
You know, they just say on sexist and we ask what is sexist in it, but now when we have amended it, now when we have changes those things, then I don't think any concept of being sexist exists.
36, 24, 36, it is mentioned in the aarti and like Jai Damdami Mata, hum apko raat ko sochte hai, din mein chahte hai, toh aise bahut sare problematic things us aarti mein likha jata hai, jo totally ek ladki ko objectify karte hai.
Entire puja and stuff, it's for entire Hindu college and we want that each and every student of Hindu college should be satisfied this puja, then only we'll be happy.
If you see the kind of women that they choose, they are actresses who have a particular body type, skin color, hair, eyes, breasts, and then they say ki that is the, like, you know, the perfect figure that a woman should have, and if you worship a person like that, you will get a person like that.
The solution is to not objectify anybody. It's not to objectify the men or the female.
You worship somebody who is sacred, and who is sacred in the female tradition is pure, is a virgin. So again, you are putting women on a pedestal and saying this is how a woman should be.
मैं ये बता दूँ उन्हें खबरदार कर दूँ कि हिंदू का हर एक मेरा भाई, मेरी बहन अपने आंतरिक मामले सुलझाने में सक्षम है.
It's not like women have not felt uncomfortable before and today suddenly they're standing up. It's just that women students are more collectivized today to stand up against this practice and say that it is wrong.
We tried to have a lot of negotiations with them and tried to explain it to them, but they are taking it very lightly, very comically.
And this joke is purely only for male pleasure. So anytime a woman stands up against something where she's been made to feel uncomfortable, it's always, why is this affecting you so much? It's a joke. Why don't you laugh about it?
मेरे ख्याल से यूथ का फेस्टिवल है तो इसे एंजॉय करने पे ज्यादा ध्यान देना चाहिए.
I'm not against the representation of sexuality or expression of sexuality. I think it is highly necessary. Desire is something that both men and women feel on a daily basis, and we do need a positive way to celebrate it without it being hijacked or decided by a bunch of men.